Hey, this is John with Circuit Board Medics. I'm here to show you how to remove your TIPM, which is a totally integrated power module out of Dodge, Chrysler, and Jeep vehicles. Here at Circuit Board Medics, we repair TIPMs by replacing faulty components and repairing circuitry. We rebuild TIPMs out of Dodge, Chrysler, and Jeep vehicles. Check out our website for a full list of makes and models that we work on and symptoms that we repair for. Also check out our phone number here and give us a call if you have any questions. I will be removing this TIPM out of a 2007 Dodge Ram 1500. A similar removal process will apply to a variety of Dodge, Chrysler, and Jeep vehicles. As always, when working with electronic components on a vehicle, first disconnect the negative battery terminal. Your particular model may have other components blocking access to the TIPM, which will need to be removed before beginning this process. Once you have gained access to your TIPM, your first step is to remove the positive battery lead from the TIPM. This can be located outside of the TIPM or underneath the cover with the fuses and relays. Once you have removed the positive battery lead, unlatch the mounting tabs to release the TIPM and uncover the plugs. We've pulled out three different TIPMs from various vehicles in order to show you the connectors that you'll see and the different locking mechanisms that you may run into. On this first type, you have the lock, the latch button, and the latch itself. You'll want to push down to unlock the lock, push on this button here to release the latch. Once the latch is released, you'll want to pull up on the connector and down on the latch at the same time in order to release the connector. To put the connector back in, do the reverse process. Press down while pulling up on the latch until it clicks into place and seat the lock. On this type of connector, there is one locking latch that will need to be pressed in order to release the connector. And you can release each one as you go. To put these back in, just push down until they snap into place. They are color-coded and they can only go into one slot. This TIPM is similar to the first and it has the same two types of connectors. There's a third that is slightly different, but it has the same push tab to unlock and remove. When putting the connector back in, simply press down until it clicks. For this TIPM, we've already covered two similar plugs. These two plugs here don't have a lock on them, they just latch and unlatch with the lever. So you can remove that. For this particular plug, there is a lock up at the top. And release the lock, press down on this button here while you're pulling the plug out. For this type of connector, you have a latch and a latch release. Press down on the latch release while pulling up on the latch in order to pull the connector out of the TIPM. When putting this connector back into the TIPM, be sure to open the latch past this tab before inserting it into the TIPM. As you insert it, press down on the tab to release the latch and push down to lock in place. When putting this connector back in the TIPM, be sure the lock is opened. Insert the plug into the TIPM and then lock the tab. When putting these two plugs back into the TIPM, simply insert and close the latch. We hope this video has been helpful. If you're having issues with your Dodge, Jeep, or Chrysler TIPM, check out our website at circuitboardmedics.com or give us a call at 1-800-547-2049.